This day and age we're living in gives cause for apprehension, with speed and new invention and things like third dimension. Yet we get a trifle weary with Mr. Einstein's theory. So we must get down to earth at times, relax, relieve the tension. No matter what the progress or what may yet be proved, the simple facts of life are such they cannot be removed. You must remember this: a kiss is still a kiss, a sigh is just a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say I love you. On that you can rely. No matter what the future brings as time goes by. Moonlight and love songs never out of date. Hearts full of passion, jealousy and hate. Woman needs man, and man must have his mate. That no one can deny. It's still the same old story, a fight for love and glory, a case of do or die. The world will always welcome lovers as time goes by. what to say, where to start. I'll just tell you what's in my heart. Life is beautiful in every way. Life is lovely as a spring bouquet. Since I fell in love with you, life is like a dream that has come true. For life is sunshine smiling brightly on a summer day. Life is rainbows chasing all the clouds of gray. Life is beautiful and fine, but darling, only because you're mine. But darling, only because you're
Good evening, everybody. My name is James Thomas Kell, Navy veteran, and this is my fellow sailor, William English Nolan Sr. And he really is my senior because he's 3 years older and he also served on a larger boat. My transport ship, the General T.H. Bliss, entered service in March of 1944, transporting 3,600 Marines from San Francisco to New Caledonia. During our short period of service, which ended in 1946, we visited New Guinea, the Panama Canal, New York, Newport, Boston, England, France, Italy, North Africa, India, Guam, Japan, and finally back to Seattle. My joy was bringing veterans home from fighting in the Pacific.
That's great. Unfortunately, my service involved transporting 188 soldiers and Marines to the beach at one time during the battles of Borneo and the southern Philippines. I served aboard the Landing Craft Infantry Large 700, which entered service in June of 1944 and was decommissioned in March of 1946.
I don't know which was harder, James, working at Ingalls building warships before I was drafted or sailing on them.
I don't know either, William, but I do know that we formed strong bonds of friendship with our fellow sailors, which survived time and distance.
Well, I guess you are fortunate enough to ponder the meaning of life. Unfortunately, some other Pascagoula residents, Pascagoula sailors, paid the ultimate sacrifice, like Lieutenant J.G.,
Douglas K. Haig, who was lost at sea after his plane went down off North African coast in 1943, and Ensign Joseph W. Shepherd, who was lost during the Battle of Leyte Gulf in 1944.
Well, I believe Harold Goche wanted us also to mention about some of the Hollywood celebrities that also served during World War II. Y'all probably all remember the famous actor Paul Newman. Paul served aboard the USS Bunker Hill, which survived a kamikaze attack during the Battle of Okinawa. And there were several other Hollywood celebrities that also served, just to name a few: Lee Marvin, Tony Curtis, Eddie Arnold.
There were people that weren't necessarily celebrities, but still local Pascagoula people, one being William R. Portis. He's buried right over there under that black granite headstone. He was a machinist mate on landing craft in the Pacific Theater. One of his final deployments in the Pacific was in Iwo Jima, and then he finished his naval time patrolling off Israel in 1948. And he may not be a celebrity, but Lieutenant Ernst Quinn Goche served on board the supply ship with the author of the story, Mr. Roberts. I wonder if he was the inspiration for the character of Ensign Culver.
Hey, I wouldn't be surprised, but I guess we better let these people continue on their tour.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm Command Sergeant Mason Gray Farrell. I want to include my middle name.
Yeah, yeah.
My gray, back when those ladies were thin, right off the design. And but for these nights, guys like myself, the guy I'm getting ready to introduce, you get to come back for one night and talk, because I think it's good to learn history. I was a student at Pascagoula High School when World War II broke. And I even took a course called Aeronautics Technology way back then. They had 12 of us in that class. I was thrilled to qualify. And it kind of helped us get a jump start on what if we did join the military and go to war. So we learned some things. Now, I didn't do that immediately because I graduated from dear old PHS in May of 1944. And I went off to what we call PERC. A lot of y'all know that is now Mississippi Gulf Coast Community College, and I was the best singer in the glee club.
Oh.
And I think I maybe could have been a celebrity, but I got this little notice, and it was Uncle Sam, we need you. And I didn't even hesitate. I went straight up to Camp Shelby, signed up November 2nd, actually, 1944, the little anniversary coming up here, and joined the effort. And I was in the war for the duration, and several years afterwards, I liked the military, enjoyed my time in the Army. And I laughed about being a celebrity a while ago. I think I could have been. I was a good singer. But that's okay, because we did have a lot of real celebrities from around here. There were many Pascagoulans who were heroes in World War II, but none more decorated than the gentleman that I'm sharing this stage with tonight. This is Lieutenant Colonel Lionel Bonham, one of the original Tuskegee Airmen. Give him a hand.
Wow. Thank you, Chief. I don't consider myself a celebrity. You know, we're talking the 40s, and there was a struggle for me to become a pilot, you know, for African Americans back then. Times were different, but I had a mother that told me I can be anything that I wanted to be, and I think Uncle Sam got that from her saying that. Heroes of the war, I think about Brigadier General Jimmy Stewart, Clark Gable. I mean, these guys received so many medals for their service in the military. A matter of fact, Hitler put a $5,000 bounty on Clark's head during the war because he was so proficient at what he did. But one of the things, when I left the war, what I did was to help other African Americans realize their hopes and dreams, not only in the military, but in all facets of life.
Oh, no doubt. Now, we did not know each other during the war, but when I came, we both came back to Pascagoula after the war, and I knew of him because the Tuskegee Airmen, that story was even growing back then because all the wonderful things they did. So I do sir, believe you are and were a celebrity, because think about it, there's been two major motion pictures made about them. One of them was Tuskegee Airmen, and the other one was Red Tails, which was done by George Lucas. I recommend them highly. So, sir, I believe you are a celebrity.
Well, Chief, again, thank you for those kind words. But when I think of a celebrity or hero in the military, I think of John Donovan Gochet. John Donovan Gochet survived the Bataan Death March, on where 76,000 U.S. soldiers and Filipino soldiers went on a 80-mile walk, and over 10,000 people died. Now, I was raised as a Christian, and so I had my faith to rely on, but there were others that did not have that to lean on.
But you and I had that to lean on. I had a good old Pascagoula Methodist and Baptist over there, and it helped. It helped. And I just feel like, you know, if you look back, Lieutenant Colonel, the things that they taught us early yes. on in the military, one thing we learned in the Army was that you had to have the will to fight and the will to win. And it would serve you not just on the battlefield, but in life as well. And you also remember, I really liked them. Remember those training films they used to show us to keep us all jacked up? Those were pretty good.
Well, Hollywood producer Frank Capra, they recalled Frank back into the military in World War II. In World War I, Frank was badly injured. And really, he was not medically qualified to even come back into the military. But he made these short films, and it was great for morale for us, and it was really helped us to get through some trying times.
Oh, there's no question about it. And Frank Capra, It's a Wonderful Life, my favorite movie.
Yeah.
He did so much for America during World War II, as did so many. But I got to ask you now, that his short films were great, and those training films were good, but those weren't the only reason you became a lifer in the service.
Well, Chief, I came back home here to Pascagoula. I married my childhood sweetheart, Marie Antoinette Barrial. And I've often said this, she didn't take my breath away, she put it back.
Yes.
And both of us married up, really.
We did.
You know, we had 8 children, and I'm gonna go off script here.
Yes.
This is one of Leonel Bonham's daughters.
Oh, wow.
Anna Bonham.
Number 2 in the 8.
My second child. And every time I see her, because I played this part before, I'm like, hey, daughter. And she's like, hey, dad. And Wayne Lee's and Jerry Lee's. So, going back.
And people that know both of us are like, But be sure to say hello to him when you're downtown, the banner wall.
Yes.
Right there between downtown. Trent Lott and Admiral Farragut. Yes.
That's me.
That's him.
The man himself.
Yes. One of the things about my service in World War II is very unique, because not many people have done this. I served in World War II, the Korean War, and the Vietnam War.
Wow.
Pretty amazing.
Yes, and so once I retired from the Air Force, I came back here, built a home here, and at the end of North Market Street, that home still stands today.
I had Burial's Grocery, right?
Yeah.
Across the street from the old Burial's Grocery.
Well, the one thing I thought about as Lieutenant Colonel, I've talked about our military careers, is perhaps I should have joined or been drafted sooner. Remember, I went in November of 1944. Within 9 months, we had whipped the Germans and the Japanese, and maybe I should have got in sooner. So many people helped out with that effort. And Pascagoula can be as proud as any town its size in the United States of America what people here have done. We're really glad y'all came tonight, because it means you care about history. History is so important. Think about, if not joining, becoming somewhat involved with the Jackson County Historical and Genealogical Society, or perhaps for the Point Krebs Foundation. Go visit that GI museum over in Gochee. It's pretty neat. And I want to tell you about one new thing. We are developing a Mississippi Maritime Museum over on DuPont Avenue in Pascagoula. A great way to celebrate all the wonderful ships that have been made right here to help the military for all this time, all over the years. It's good to be a Pascagoulan and be involved with the military.
Absolutely. And we thank you guys for coming out. We do have a tip jar. Going off script again, I am your president and CEO of your United Way for Jackson.